Good afternoon all, I'm Dr. Athulya. I'll be presenting a case report on rapidly progressing unilateral proptosis in a young boy as initial manifestation of acute myeloid leukemia. Introduction: acute myeloid leukemia accounts for nearly 15% of all leukemias in children, and mainly it will present as cytopenic symptoms like anemia, recurrent infection, or thrombocytopenia like recurrent bleeding, but proptosis as initial sign is not very common. Extramedullary infiltration of leukemic cells, granulocytic sarcoma, is an unusual manifestation of AML, accounting for about 3%. Ocular manifestations of leukemia usually occur during course of the disease. Estimated unilateral proptosis is 40% and bilateral proptosis is 60% in patients of myeloid leukemia. Literature review suggests that leukemia might be the most likely diagnosis in a child with soft tissue orbital tumors. Materials and methods. We report a case of 9-year-old boy presenting with rapidly progressing painless swelling in right eye associated with diminution of vision. Fellow eye showed mild eyelid swelling and was otherwise normal. Patient has occasional fever since 3 months. On examination, general build was lean and there was no lymphadenopathy or organomegaly. Remaining systemic examination were normal. Coming to ocular examination, right eye vision was hand movement close to face, extraocular movements restricted in all gaze, lids swollen, conjunctiva was chemosed, cornea was hazy, and anterior chamber was normal. Pupil regular round sluggish reacting, lens and fundus could not examine due to corneal edema. Left eye was normal, only mild lid swelling was there and mild congestion of conjunctiva. Immediately we just gave lubricant drop only, then we had sent the routine investigation. Investigation came WBC count as 10,000 and hemoglobin 9.8, and differential count showed 70% of blast cells and it was positive for aurods. So we had sent a hematology opinion. They have advised to do peripheral blood smear. Peripheral blood smear showed aurods, and bone marrow biopsy did that showed sheets of blast cells in bone marrow biopsy, and flow cytometry which showed cluster of CD45 dimmed region with moderate expression of CD33, CD34, CD117, CD38, and myeloperoxidase conformatory for AML M2 type. CCT shows homogeneously enhancing soft tissue lesion in extracorneal compartment of bilateral eyes, right more than left, with involvement of the lacrimal glands. So treatment started with chemotherapy with donorubicin and cytarabine, induction therapy 3+7, regimen, donorubicin 60 mg per meter square, day 1 to day 3, then cytarabine 100 mg per meter square, day 1 to 7 was given. Then after 28 days, repeated the bone marrow, and they have started, it showed that patient is in remission phase, and started with consolidation therapy, high dose cytarabine 3 gram per meter square twice, daily for 3 alternative days, day 1, 3 and 5, prophylactic antimicrobial agents given. This was the photo on day 1 of chemotherapy, then after 1 month and after 2 months. After 2 months though, we could examine fundus. There were no optic nerve involvement and there were no retinal hemorrhages. Discussion: main consideration in children presenting with bilateral orbital masses are idiopathic non-granulomatous inflammation, metastatic neuroblastoma and granulocytic sarcoma. Literature shows 60 to 80% of orbital granulocytic sarcoma are bilateral. Peripheral blood smear evaluation was the important step which helped for the diagnosis. Early diagnosis and treatment can improve the prognosis and eventual outcome. Conclusion: granulocytic sarcoma is an important cause of bilateral childhood proptosis, and peripheral blood smear is the inexpensive test which we can do for all those cases which help for the early diagnosis and management. Thank you.
It's nice, like you did our follow up and you were involved in this patient. And what was the visual acuity at the end of 2 months?
At the end of 2 months, it was like 6-9, sir. Six and fundus examination was also normal.
Mm. You had been involved in this patient's treatment. What you had actually thought of other things?
No, actually, sir, like hematology side only, they have given the treatment, but we have done usual follow-up. Whenever the patient comes to hematology, they used to come for ophthalmic checkup also. So we used to see the visual acuity also and the symptoms, whether it's subsiding and signs also, sir.
And okay. Initially, you said your first clinical diagnosis was pseudotumor. Anything else you could think of looking at the clinical picture?
Sir, metastatic neuroblastoma is also another differential diagnosis.
Okay, no, because there's significant lid edema and all that, which is not generally seen
cellulitis.
In pseudotumor. Yeah, cellulitis-like picture, which is not generally seen with pseudotumor.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.